And in the past, we would like to have at least the members of the guests just quickly stand up and say who you are. A lot of you know who each other. You want to start with that? I'm ready to meet you, by the way.
I'm his wife, Jacqueline Payne.
Bob Hall.
John G. West.
Jamie Strauss.
I'm Cliff Holmes.
I'm Gary Good.
John Young.
Mike Robinson.
Dave Hall.
John Gauss.
Bonnie Fuller.
George McNeil.
Britta.
Barbara Case.
Nick Ware.
Arpawa Sitter.
Sophia Howard.
Cliff Weaver, I'm a visitor.
Bob Hillis.
Brett Shepard, I'm a member.
Chris Myers, I'm a member.
Susan Gansey, who's over here.
Mark Browning, member.
Jane Lightman.
Jim Fuller.
Charles Manning.
Louis Wheaton.
Roy Holder.
Oliver Richards.
Eric Lightman.
Steve Sears.
Bill Rocher.
Okay, let's begin with our invocation from our chaplain, Bob Hall.
We bow your heads. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for our organization. We pray that it might thrive both locally and at the state level and nationally. We thank you for our great country. We pray for its leaders. We thank you for those who made so many sacrifices for us to have this country and to keep it. We pray for those also who remember the sacrifices that our patriots have made for us. We thank you for those who keep alive the memories of what those brave soldiers have done for us. We pray for our soldiers all around the world. Keep them safe. We pray a special blessing on all the people who are here today and on our families. And we pray for those who are not able to be with us today. We ask all this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Now the girl is there for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And before we stand, we'll say our trust in our pledge. It's on the agenda.
We descend into the heroes of the American Revolution, who by their sacrifices established the United States of America, reaffirm our faith in the principles of liberty and our constitutional republic, and solemnly pledge ourselves to defend them.
Thank you. wide to commemorate our fellow members. We have answered the last call since our last society meeting. The chaplain broke his arm.
Mr. President, compatriots, I am at your service and shall endeavor to perform the solemn duty in the spirit of true Christian faith. Mr. President, to whom should we look for help in life's battles?
Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Mr. President, what assurance do we have of a prolonged stay among the scenes and activities of this life?
For we are strangers before thee and sojourners, as were all our fathers. Our days on earth are as a shadow, and there is none like it.
Mr. President, do you have a message of condolence?
The Holy Bible tells us, like as a father pities his children, so the Lord pities them that fear him. For he knows our frame, he remembers that we are just.
And I too have a message of condolence for all patriots and their families that should inspire us now at this solemn moment and all throughout life. This message is from Christ, the head of the church, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever believeth in me shall never die. Compatriots, let us so live that when that last summons comes for us, we may depart this life. And today we think of Alfred Bauer Sr., who died in June at age 96. So let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, in silent reverence, we recognize the truth of your inspired words. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he was dead, yet shall he live. As patriots answer your final summons, we ask that you look with mercy upon our families and with your own tenderness, console and comfort them. And now, our Heavenly Father, bless our country with freedom, peace, and righteousness. Through your favor, may we all meet at last before your throne in glory. All this we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Mr. President, I have a comment that I would like to make about Alfred Bauer Sr. Alfred Bauer was a member of my church, Methodist Temple in Evansville. And Alfred, in his last days, was in quite poor health, and he had to be taken to church in a wheelchair. But even though he was so far up in years, he did faithfully show up for church. He was relatively infirm, but I think that he made a powerful statement with his presence in church, and I think that it made a statement to the other Christians to see how the effort that Al Bauer was putting into being able to come and worship during service. And I think, too, of Alfred and how that he wanted to become a member of the SAR, and he was persistent, and then finally his papers were approved, and he became a member of our group. We certainly remember the Alfred Bauer and his example that he set for all of us.
I might add one comment. His paper was sent in, as we all know, with 1 to 5. Somehow, it was misplaced in the National Office. And actually, he wanted to join me. He had a paper, he wanted to honor him. He didn't give up. 10 years later, it was found and approved. And he was so happy, and he had come to the David, he was a man of honor and stuff, but. Next on the agenda, we've got our program, Missing Table, and by the Rolling Thunder, Indiana Chapter 6. And so I'll hand it over to the presenter.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
My name is Jim Fuller, and I'm a member of Rolling Thunder, Indiana Chapter 6. Before we start the Missing Man Table presentation, I would like to tell you a little bit about Rolling Thunder. Rolling Thunder was founded in 1987 by two Vietnam veterans, Artie Mueller and Ray Munzio, from New Jersey, with the sole purpose of keeping the POW MIA issues in front of the politicians and the general public, knowing we still have POWs and MIAs from all wars. Our first demonstration ride in Washington, D.C. was in 1988, with 2,500 motorcycles participating. As of this past year, every Memorial Day weekend, Rolling Thunder rides to Washington, D.C. with an average of 1 million motorcycles, cars, trucks participating in our demonstration ride. And you did notice I said demonstration ride, just not a parade. The good thing about Rolling Thunder is you do not have to be a military veteran or ride a motorcycle to belong. We are not a motorcycle club. We are an organization that has one mission. And our mission statement is, the major function of Rolling Thunder Incorporated is to publicize the POW-MIA issues, to educate the public that many American prisoners of war were left behind after all previous wars, and to help correct the past and to protect the future veterans from being left behind should they become prisoners of war, missing in action. We are also committed to helping American veterans from all wars. And now I would like to introduce our narrator, Ms. Jane Blakeman, and the missing man, Tate.
And the families of our missing comrades who keep the faith while awaiting
plight, is to remind us of their bitter fate. The salt on the plate represents a tear shed by both the missing and their families who still seek answers. The Bible is a symbol of strength gained through faith, which sustains those serving our country, founded as one nation under God. The glasses are inverted. They cannot toast with us at this time. The candle is reminiscent of a light of hope that lives in our hearts to illuminate their way home to the open arms of a grateful nation. The chairs are empty. They are not here. Let us remember and never forget their sacrifice. Sergeant at Arms, take charge of retail.
DJ, but. Freeze in arms.
I understood.